with our musical theme, our next guest has been called the voice of a generation. Pete Townshend is a founding member of The Who and has lived the life of a rock god. And now he's detailing it all in his new book, Who Am I? And he's joining us live now from New York to talk about it. Please welcome The Who's Pete Townshend. Good to see you.
Hi, Carrie. It's Who I Am. My book is called Who I Am.
Oh, Who I Am, not Who Am I. Why did you finally decide to write this book?
It's just time. I'm 67. If I wait any longer, I'll be dead. I should be dead, but...
You should be dead. Well, I guess you have described yourself as that reluctant rock star. What did you mean by that?
You know, I never felt comfortable in the role. You know, I really never did feel... I still don't, really. I think there are many other things that I was an art student. I wanted to be an artist. That's really what I wanted to be. But, you know, started to make money in a band very early, happened to be in a great band. I was very lucky. And so I did what I was, I did what destiny laid in front of me.
I was really surprised to read that you admit that performing at Woodstock elevated The Who to rock legends, but you say you really didn't like performing there.
It was an unpleasant experience in many ways. It was, by the time we got there, it was a bit of a mess. So, yeah, I didn't really like it, but I loved what it did for us. The one great thing about Woodstock for me was seeing Sly and the Family Stone playing live. They were so hot. They were so fantastic. I wish people could see them in their heyday. They were quite extraordinary, and I was lucky to see them.
I know a lot of people would probably want to know what your relationship is like with Roger Daltrey these days.
It's great. It's really great. I think, you know, that's probably to do with the fact that we're both older. But it was never that bad. You know, what we've never been able to do, which is very sad, is we've never been able to sit and write a song together. But in all other respects, we've had very separate roles. You know, he's the front man, and I'm the guy in the back that's trying to steal his thunder.
No kidding. Hey, you also wrote that, and I was surprised to see this, that Mick Jagger is the only man you ever wanted to sleep with. So were you worried about sharing such intimate details like that?
Well, it's obviously a bit of an English joke.
Right.
I don't know whether you guys just don't get English humor.
Sometimes,
but,
no.
There were a few others. I think what I was talking about was Mick's extraordinary androgynous sexuality. That in the early 60s, the pop stars were starting to become less masculine, less trying to look like big hunky guys like Dean Martin, and you know, it didn't matter that we looked a bit effeminate. And I think therefore what I was talking about was the fact that, you know, that those issues, those performances started to make us realize that all of that stuff was ridiculous. And thank heavens now that kind of stuff doesn't mean as much as it did back then.
Is it true that you are banned from Holiday Inns for the rest of your life?
That can't be true, because I think I've been to a few, but Keith Moon had this outrageous 21st birthday party, which is ridiculous because he was only 20, and the Holiday Inn, I think in Flint, Michigan, put on a great display for him, and that's where the legendary Lincoln Continental ended up in the swimming pool. I write about it in the book. And I don't write about it in a funny way. I was very angry about the whole thing. And as a result of that party, which was cake flying in the air and cars getting smashed up, Keith lost his front teeth, we got banned. And I remember the ban being imposed, but I don't remember it being lifted. So well, I'm assuming I'm still banned.
You jumped off the balcony, right?
Keith once, I was following Keith down a balcony, and he flipped over and jumped into a swimming pool.
Oh, gosh.
Below us. And I did the same thing, and I realized that he'd rehearsed it.
Oh.
He'd actually practiced doing it.
That's not fair.
And I'd misjudged the distance. I didn't look, and I was falling right towards the edge of the pool. I managed to wriggle and just slide down the edge. He was often doing that kind of thing. Once he put a dumpster outside a window full of mattresses, and during a party he walked out and jumped out of the window. And we all thought he'd killed himself.
Oh, my gosh.
He was so funny.
I'm looking forward to this book. You certainly have a lot to say, and with a twist of humor. So we appreciate you coming on, Mr. Townshend. You truly are a legend.
Oh, thank you, Carrie. And I'm so I love Dallas, and I'm so looking forward to coming back one day soon.
Come and see us, okay? Next time you're in town.
Maybe I can. Yeah, maybe I can.
Okay.
That would be great.
We'll be waiting for you. All right. The book is Who I Am, and it arrives in stores today.